In this video, I am going to discuss about crystal field theory. First, let us know what are the applications of crystal theory and then what is crystal field theory. The applications of crystal field theory is, by using crystal field theory, we can able to find magnetic properties as well as color. This crystal field theory was developed by Hans Bethe and John Hansbaum. Why this crystal field theory have been developed? Because valence bond theory fails to explain the stability of coordination compounds and difference between strong and weak ligands. This valence bond theory cannot able to explain. That's why the crystal field theory have been developed by Hans Bethe. What crystal field theory says? Crystal field theory says that the electrostatic interaction between metal ions and ligands. Crystal field theory says that metal ligand bond has an ionic bond arising purely from electrostatic interactions between metal ion and ligands. Here what we need to quote, metal ion and ligands have some electrostatic interaction between. That we need to remember. Crystal field theory means what? Electrostatic interactions between metal ions and ligands. Crystal field theory describes the breaking of orbital degeneracy in transition metal complexes due to the presence of ligands. Crystal field theory qualitatively describes the strength of metal and ligand bonds. Also here, how the way copper is surrounded with the ligands. Those are the water molecules are surrounded by the ligands. Here you can see the animation. Crystal field theory qualitatively describes the strength of metal ligand bonds. Based on the strength of the metal ligand bonds, the energy of the system is altered. D orbitals are classified into 5 types. They are dxy orbital, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, dz square. The names tell you that these orbitals lie in the xy plane, the xy plane and yz plane respectively. Each orbital has 4 lobes. Notice that each of the lobe is pointing between 2 of the axes, not along them. You can observe that. For example, the dxy orbital has lobes that point between x and y axes. No lobes actually points in x or y direction. It is really important that for what follows that you understand that. You observe dxy, dyz and dzx all look same. But dx square minus y square and dz square will not look same. Although these two orbitals look totally different, what they have in common is that their lobes point along the various axes. That's the difference from these three where lobes points in between the axes. The dx square minus y square orbital looks exactly like first group apart of x and y axes, not in between them. The dz square looks like a p orbital wearing a collar. The main lobe point along the z-axis. Field theory considers anions as point charges and neutral molecules as dipoles. When transition metals are not bonded to any ligand, their d orbitals are degenerate. That is, they have the same energy. When they start bonding with the other ligand due to different symmetries of the d orbitals and inductive effect of the ligands on the electrons and the d orbitals split apart and become non-degenerate. In case of an octahedral coordination compound having 6 ligands surrounding the metal atom, we observe repulsion between the electrons in d orbitals and ligand electrons. This repulsion is experienced more in the case of dx square, y square and dz square orbitals as a point towards the axes along the direction of the ligand. In octahedral geometry, the splitting occurs in two different types. First one is T2G and second one is EG. T2G means what? Triple gerade. And EG means what? Double gerade. In T2G, it's a stretch of three orbitals. Set up three orbitals having dxy, dyz and dzx with a lower energy. That's why the T2G orbitals I have shown down and EG orbitals I have shown up. EG orbitals having dx square minus y square and dz square. Here you can see how the filling of electrons are occurring in each d orbital one by one. This is the way how the electrons will fill in all the d orbitals here. Here, the splitting of degenerate level in the presence of ligand is known as crystal field splitting. The difference between energy of T2G and EG level is denoted with delta naught. Some ligands tend to produce strong fields, thereby causing large crystal field splitting, whereas some ligands tend to produce weak field, thereby causing small crystal field splitting. Thus, the crystal field splitting depends upon the field produced by ligand on the charge on the metal ion. The main pattern of splitting of d orbitals depend upon the nature of the crystal field. The splitting in various fields is discussed here. You can see after. If you come to square planar complexes, there are four ligands and the electrons of the ligands are only attached to xy plane. Any orbital in xy plane has higher energy level. So there are four energy levels for the square planar, from highest to lowest energy level. What they are? Dx square minus y square, dxy, dz square and both dxz and dyz as shown in this figure. The splitting in square planar geometry from highest to lowest, that is dx square y square to dxz and dyz. So the square planar complexes are usually low spin. Example for this is NiCN4 2+. If in the case of tetrahedral complexes, there are four ligands attached to the central metal ion, the d orbitals also split into two different energy levels, same as like if you see in the octahedral geometry. The top three higher energy levels consist of dxy, dyz and dzx orbitals. The bottom two lower energy levels consist of dx square minus y square and dz square orbitals. The reason for this is due to poor orbital overlap between the metal ion and ligands. The orbitals are directed on the axes while the ligands are not. The difference in splitting of energy is tetrahedral splitting, which is less than delta naught. Delta naught is octahedral complexes. The change in energy in octahedral complexes and delta T is the change in energy level in tetrahedral geometry. Here in this, the energy will be less than the octahedral complexes, typically smaller than spin-spin energy. So the tetrahedral complexes usually possesses high spin